like you. Let them fall like showers on the new grass, like abundant rain on plants. For I will proclaim Yahweh's great name, praise the greatness of Yahweh. He is the rock, his works are perfect, Yahweh's ways are justice indeed. He is the Father of truth and does no wrong, upright and just is he. Corruptly they boundaries for the people according to the number of the sons of Israel. Yahweh's portion is his people, Yaakov is his allotted inheritance. He found him in a desert land, in a waste and howling wilderness. Yahweh led him and instructed him. He guarded him as the apple of his eye. As the eagle stirs up her nest, as she flutters over her young, spreading her wings to catch them, taking the young and holding them up. So Yahweh alone did lead him, and no God at all was with him. Yahweh made Yaakov ride on the high places of the earth, so he might eat the increase of the field, and suck honey from the rock, and suck oil from the flinty rock, with butter and milk from herd and flock, fatted lambs and Bashan rams, the fattest goats and the finest kernels of wheat. And you drank the pure blood of the grape. But Yeshurun grew fat and kicked, you are waxed fat and grown thick. With this thickness you are covered. He then forsook great Yahweh, who lightly esteemed the rock his Savior. They provoked Yahweh to jealousy with their gods. They provoked him to anger with this abomination. They sacrificed to demons which are not of Yahweh, to gods. they did not know. To God's newly come up, to God's your fathers did not worship. You are unmindful of, and you forgot the rod that begot you, our Father who formed you. When Yahweh saw them, he abhorred them, because his sons and daughters provoked him. And he said, I will hide my face from them. I will see what their end shall be. For they are a perverse generation, children in whom is no faith. They provoked me to jealousy by that which has no power. They provoked me to anger with their worthless gods. I will make them jealous by those who are not a people. I will provoke them to anger by a people that has no them and make their remembrance cease from among them. But I dreaded the taunts of the enemy, because the adversary would misunderstand. Were wise. Oh. that they could understand this. Oh, that they could discern what their latter end will be. Oh, that this nation were wise. How can one man chase 1,000 unless their ark had sold them? And to put 10,000 to flight unless Yahweh had delivered them up? For their rock is not as our rock. Our enemies have even conceded this. For their vines are vines of Sodom, and from the fields of Gomorrah, their grapes are the grapes of God. Their clusters are filled with bitterness. Their wine is the dragon's poison, and the cruel venom of asps. Is not this laid in the storehouse with me, sealed up among my treasures? Vengeance and recompense is mine, their foot shall slip in due time. Their day of disaster is near, their day shall be at hand, and their doom rushes upon them. O Yahweh will judge his people and have compassion upon his servants. When he sees that their power is gone, and no one is left, bond or free, then he will ask, where are your gods, your rock in whom you trusted? Where are your gods who ate your sacrifices and drank the wine of your drink offerings? Let your gods rise up and help you. Let them be your protection. And there is no God with me. Me I kill and I make alive, I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand. I lift my hand to heaven and declare, I live forever. When I sharpen my blasting sword, when my hand takes hold of judgment, I will take vengeance upon my foes. I will reward those who hate me. I will make my arrows drunk with blood, and my sword will devour flesh of the slain and of the captives, with the beginning of revenge upon the enemy. Rejoice, O nation, and let all his monarchy worship him. He is the avenger of blood for his servants. Yahweh will
judge and execute vengeance upon his enemies and make atonement for his land.